sponsors, Obsession Bulls, Vortex Optics.
Well, we went down and recovered both the animals. We drug them up here by the trucks. Just give one last little thought. And again, it's November 6th.
We are going to tag it, gun it, and drag it home. This beautiful whitetail.
Welcome to the Whitetail Obsession. This week we're in the middle of September, and we're going to start with the doe hunt, and then I believe we're going to roll into a buck hunt with Karl over here.
Yep, we're going to start with Cody's doe hunt though first.
Yep, me and my cousin who I'd filmed the weekend before actually snuck out into one of our honey holes, and we had a doe come in, and you'll see what happens from there.
Basically the same spot you and Michael shot his buck at it.
Yep, not 70 yards away. So.
It's just a great spot, inside corner hunt, so... And then the next hunt you're going to see is a 10 pointer with me. Would have been a couple years back, Cody's first time filming, so that was pretty exciting for him. Bow hunt, we had patterned these deer as a buck I called James Dean. My wife actually named him. He's a real pretty 3-year-old 10 pointer. Not a huge deer, but a great buck to take, and we were definitely having him on our hit list. So.
And that was actually a property where, how many acres is that?
That acreage is only 20 acres, I think.
Yeah, so not a big spot, but decent bucks on it.
Yeah, it's kind of a travel corridor, so you guys will be able to check this hunt out.
In all weather, in all spring, you get that hunt of a lifetime, the tag you've been waiting years for. Trust Vortex Optics Performance. When you need to make that shot of a lifetime, right on the animal you need to be hunting. Trust Vortex for the shot of a lifetime.
Here's a little applied physics lesson about precision and consistency. When two or more tested measurements are equal, that's called precision. When you achieve a level of performance with little or no variation in quality over time, that's called consistency. Accuracy is a level of measurement that delivers true and consistent results. Put precision and consistency together, that's called VeinTech. VeinTech, precision flows through our veins.
I block the wind, the cold. I block the rain. Noise and smells. I block the voice in your head that says, go home. Scent blocker.
Finally, a frustration-free lighted knock. The Knockout by Clean Shot Archery. The most reliable shot-activated lighted knock system available. It works perfectly, shot after shot. Universal fit with adapter sleeves to match today's most popular arrow diameters. Easy on, easy off. Knockout Lighted Knocks installs in seconds using no glue and features a practice mode. Ask for Knockout Lighted Knocks at your local dealer.
It's September 19th and we're actually back in the stand that we sat in last weekend. But we had to move because the wind wasn't quite right. We had a couple does come out of this spot and then eventually later on in that night we actually had a doe walk probably 20 yards underneath the stand. So tonight we're after a nice big buck a little early in the season, but hopefully maybe a turkey will walk by. We got a northwest wind, which is probably the perfect wind for this stand, so especially in the evening. Michael, he's behind the camera tonight like last time. He shot his first deer last weekend, so trying to get me one this weekend, right? So
for sure.
We'll see what comes out and hopefully we'll get something on film. You never know. We might not see anything tonight. Stay with us and see what happens.
We'll be right back.
Yeah.
What has got on it?
That's got some. Those are black eagle arrows with those excess broadheads. First time I'm shooting these this year, these excess broadheads. I've never shot fixed blades before, and so far I'm impressed. There's some right there. Oh, she went this way.
Yeah, good idea. Found her.
There she is.
Found her. Before we move her up here where we want to do the little talk, we're going to validate our tag. So they actually switched the rules this year. You have to specify which county you want to shoot your doe, or yeah, just does in, and if it's private or public land. So if we're on private land, so I actually bought a bonus tag because I have my main ones for another county. So this was a PM kill.
And September, the second week.
Slit through the ear here. I don't think she'll mind. That's a little bit bigger than a slit. And she's bleeding all over me. Okay. Actually, I want to do this like this, make it look better. Like this, fill this through there. My first legally harvested whitetail of the season here in southern Wisconsin. Nice mature doe. Couldn't ask for a better hunt tonight. I mean, we only sat there for a little bit, but. All right, guys, down here in southern Wisconsin, and the second week of September has proven to be a good one, along with the first week. Not to mention, I think this is just an awesome spot. We shot a lot of deer out of this corner over the past couple years, seen a lot of nice deer, and we were lucky enough to have this beautiful adult doe come in tonight. She had two fawns with her, and we've actually been watching this doe quite often. They seem to come out here every night, about 4:35 o'clock every night, and
they slowly make their way down to this end of the field, and we've sat on other tree stands and they won't come close enough, and we're pretty sure she was just going to drop in down below us here tonight with her two fawns like they normally do, but as luck would have it, they started walking up towards us back this way and got a shot on her. It's a little high, high lung, but the angle of the tree, me shooting downwards, actually made it a pretty good shot. So double lunged her. She probably ran 80 yards downhill. So that's just a testament to the Exodus broadheads. I mean, they put a pretty nice cut through them. Black Eagle arrows shot real good. And the Obsession bow, just unreal. So quiet, so quick, she didn't have time to drop, which, I mean, will sometimes happen. She just was gone. So great night for a hunt here in southern Wisconsin on this nice mature whitetail. I got up, we got her tagged, and we'll call my uncle. I think we're gonna wrap it up with that tonight. So thanks for watching us, Team Rush Outdoors down here in southern Wisconsin. I'm Cody Van Haren, and behind the camera is Michael Van Haren. Good luck to you guys. Nothing better than bow hunting.
Good night.
Finally, a frustration-free lighted knock. The Knockout by Clean Shot Archery. The most reliable shot-activated lighted knock system available. It works perfectly, shot after shot. Universal fit with adapter sleeves to match today's most popular arrow diameters. Easy on, easy off. Knockout Lighted Knocks installs in seconds using no glue and features a practice mode. Ask for Knockout Lighted Knocks at your local dealer.
I block the wind, the cold. I block the rain, noise and smells. I block the voice in your head that says, go home. Scent blocker.
Here's a little applied physics lesson about precision and consistency. When two or more tested measurements are equal, that's called precision. When you achieve a level of performance with little or no variation in quality over time, that's called consistency. Accuracy is a level of measurement that delivers true and consistent results. Put precision and consistency together, that's called VeinTech. VeinTech, precision flows through our veins.
In all weather, in all terrain, you get that hunt of a lifetime, the tag you've been waiting years for. Trust Vortex Optics Performance. When you need to make that shot of a lifetime, you're right on the animal you need to be hunting. Trust Vortex for the shot of a lifetime.
September 17th here in southern Wisconsin, Team Rush Outdoors. Actually hunting near the house here in the metro zone. I got my nephew Cody filming for me tonight. Mike's had to work, so it's during the week. Sunday when I sat here, I had six doe come into this bean field in this new GT food plot that I got. So hopefully we're setting up on them. We got a south wind blows our snipe up over the top of this hill. We do have some bucks in this area, five or six that we've got pictures of. Maybe one of them will show up tonight. See what happens. We got a front coming in, bringing in some rain tonight. Stick around, it could get exciting.
Thank you.
running?
Yep, you're good.
I think that was the smooth 8. We just had him come in tonight. It is, oh, I don't know. Let me look. I'm getting a text from other pro staff guys. It is September 17th, 6:42 p.m. I got my nephew Cody filming. It's his first time filming. And I could hear this deer cross the bottom. I told him just after this rain comes through, the deer are gonna move, and he come right out. I know he's probably 120, 125 inch 8-point. Come into 21 yards, cornering at me a little bit in the beans. Put the smack down on him. He didn't go very far. Here shortly, we're gonna do a recovery, and we got one down. Nice. Thanks, buddy. We just reviewed the footage. It looks like a pretty good shot. Cameraman shook a little bit, but we kind of got it on film. You see the hit and everything. It looks fairly decent. But I was mistaken. It's not the smooth 8. It's actually a buck we call James Dean. I recently got pictures of him probably starting about 3 weeks ago down here on a food plot, which is, I don't know, about 100 yards away. So looks like a pretty good hit. We're going to go down, get our arrow, and start our recovery. But we got light yet, so hopefully we'll have them in hand here shortly.
All right, well, we got blood right here. Looks pretty good. You can see he started bleeding pretty heavy right here, so we're going to head down and see if we can find him quick. Dead buck. Come on through.
He's, I don't know, 15 and a half, 16 inch inside, 10 point. He's a buck we call James Dean. I've recently gotten pictures of him. I think he's a 3-year-old. Beautiful hide on him. It's gonna make a great mount. He was quartering at me. This is the exit wound here. Come through the, that's actually lung right there, so. But put a good shot on him. He went, oh, I don't know, looks like about 65 yards and piled up. So we're going to get him out of here and take him out by one of our other areas here on the property and gut him. So got to tag him quick. We'll be done.
These are awful down here.
This buck is legal here in the state of Wisconsin. All right.
Alright guys, thanks for watching. That's the third episode of the Whitetail Obsession. As you saw, I took a doe, put a good shot on her. She didn't go too far, and then we had Karl's buck. That was just a riot.
Yeah, we had that cold front moving in. We knew it was going to rain a little bit, and I told Cody right after the rain the deer were definitely going to move, and I think it stopped raining about, 30 seconds?
Yeah.
Maybe a minute, and the buck came right out to us. So ended up being a great plan. We knew he was there. Did a little bit of scouting, and that's how that all worked out. But next week on the Whitetail Obsession, we have a couple management deer that we're going to show you guys. Myself and Wes White get an opportunity to fill the freezer. So you guys stay tuned. Thanks for watching the Whitetail Obsession.